thanks so much for joining me.
Naomi Moneypenny.
I'm excited to show you the possibilities of what we can do with your social intranet. Let's get started with looking at Yammer. You know Yammer from how to connect your organization across lots of geographies, across multiple functions, and lots of ways to connect people across your entire organization. We can think of Yammer in terms of the communities that you can create, both the communities of practice and the communities of interest, as well as just being able to put people in a place maybe where they can connect with leaders.
A conversation page.
I'm showcasing here one of the things that we do at Microsoft. We have a group for Satya, our CEO, and he's able there to share his top of mind and share his understanding about what's going on inside of the organization, while also getting great feedback from us as employees. As I scroll through, you see that I have a vibrant and rich community. People are engaging, they're sharing videos and conversations, and it's a great way to really get that top of mind and understand the voice of our employees, as well as what our senior leadership team is also thinking about.
Images and videos.
As I scroll through here, I think, okay, wouldn't it be great if I could have this conversation also be part of our intranet site? As many of you do inside of your organizations, we have intranet sites that really help to showcase the latest content, from a news perspective, maybe articles, or even blogs from our senior leaders. I can showcase this content as part of what we're doing here in a SharePoint communication site. As I scroll through, you'll see that I have great conversations available to me from my Yammer community. And I can also see that I have news articles coming, as well as understanding polls and surveys and other web parts that I might be able to feature as part of this. I can see the latest content, could be policy documents, procedures, whatever it is that you want to share. But it's really using that rich set of communication capabilities that we have built into SharePoint. So let's explore a little bit more about what we can do with Yammer and bring these conversations into what you're doing with communication sites, as well as your existing team sites.
A new SharePoint site.
I'm going to go ahead and actually create a whole new site. And we look at this new site and really pick out a template. We can think about the different options that we want to use. When I look at team sites, it's really about collaboration every single day. And so that core group of people that you're working with and understanding the focus is really the content. I'm going to choose to use a communication site. A communication site is really about broadly informing and engaging with your entire base. So it could be an audience, maybe it's something about your project that you want to share with a wide group of stakeholders inside of your organization. Or in fact, it might just be something that helps you to communicate out new information or perhaps even create a new group for a specific leader who wants to share their top of mind. So whatever you want to really inform and engage, the communication site is a great place to start. I can pick out these different layouts. For example, I've got topics, I've got a showcase site that I can pick out. So I'm going to go ahead and click topic, and we're going to give this site a name. I'm going to say it's called Leadership Connection, and it will create the site as part of this. I will click on the site description, which I could fill out later, and I can actually give it some classification information too. In this case, it's general purpose, because basically everybody in my intranet is able to access this. You can customize these site classification levels to whatever you need them to be. I'm going to click finish here, and that beautiful communication site is going to be created right away for me. One of the great things we have as part of this communication site is it makes it really easy to showcase the content that you need. When the site's created, you'll see that I get a rich set of functionality. And so when I look through here, I can see, okay, this is information. I understand what I'm supposed to do here. I've got news. I've got events, perhaps, that I want to feature, different documents, and really looking at all of that piece that's here. What I want to do, though, is make sure that I'm able to include my conversations from Yammer. I'm going to click edit, and I'll get available to me the different guides here. You'll see that I have section breaks on the side here, so I can actually create different sections as part of my page layout here.
On the left.
I could add in a couple of columns if I wanted to split the orientation, or I can just click through here and open up the WebPart gallery. When I click through, you'll see that I get all of the WebParts that are available to me as part of SharePoint. And so there's a really rich set of functionality that we have here. I can click through. You may be familiar with some of these already. The one we showed at the top of the page is called the Hero Web Part. It usually has a lot of content and images as part of it. We have Microsoft Forms, which allows us to do polling and surveying. And we've got a People Web Part that helps you to showcase maybe experts or people that you should be contacting as part of your project. And then we have Twitter and finally Yammer. So let's talk about the Yammer Web Part and how we can help make that connection between both the content of our intranet site and the conversations that you're having inside of your community. As I scroll through here, you'll see that I have some different options, but it all starts with identifying your Yammer community.
A search box.
So I'm going to type for CEO connection, and you'll see that it's automatically populated. And that auto-population is happening because I'm logged into Office 365, and it knows the Yammer communities that I have access to. I click through onto CEO connection, you'll see that I get a range of options. I can already see that there's some content coming up as part of my web part here, and you'll see that it's populating this in a great card format. I can see here that I have a range of different options. So top conversations allows me to actually feature the most popular conversations in a group. So this is a great way if you just want to engage people inside of your community. Maybe they're going to come into your community for the first time through your intranet site. So this is a good way to be able to say, here's what's popular, here's the replies, maybe the amount of likes. It's kind of a great way to showcase the conversations that are popular and really refresh all the time. You can see I also have this option here for latest conversations. And those latest conversations are personal to you. So if you've already been into the CEO Connection group in this case, and you've visited that content as part of Yammer, you're going to see the latest conversations since you were last there. This is a good way to keep up to date as much as possible with the latest in the group. And so because it's personal to you, oftentimes we think about this latest conversations piece as being a way to actually showcase information in a team site, maybe a little bit more than a communication site. But you have the option. You can choose to whichever one is most appropriate for both your site or your article or your page that you're creating and think about which is the best way that you want to engage that community. You don't have to permanently make this choice either. You can edit this setting at any time, and I'll show you how to do that later. We can also just curate different conversations specifically for this page. Because this is the homepage of my specific site, maybe there are questions that people ask all the time. Maybe there are threads that have gone on before that I think could be beneficial to everybody. And so I can actually copy and paste here different links to those specific conversations. I'm going to show you how to do that. Let's click over back to our CEO Connection group. And so, for example, if I wanted to feature Andy's conversation here on about diversity recruiting, because it's a common question that comes up, I can click through onto the ellipsis here and go to View Conversation. View Conversation will take me to a page in Yammer that basically shows that entire string of thread and helps me to get all of the content in one place. I'm going to take that URL and copy it. And then I'm going to paste it over here into this box.
A right column.
You'll see that immediately the card pops up on the side, and I can see that multiple people have replied here and that multiple people have liked the thread. And so it's a great way to be able to curate specific conversations that you want within that same group and really use that as a basis to have a springboard for your conversations. I'm going to go back to top conversations for now, and you'll see that automatically we're able to have that come up, and I'm going to click publish. And we'll scroll down, and you'll see our conversations have popped up here. If I wanted to go in and then edit this web part, it's very easy to do. Like I said before, you can change this at any time. So whatever setting is working for you, maybe you're running a specific campaign, or maybe you have a different piece of conversations that you're going to highlight, then you're able to change that at any time. I'll click edit here.
Top right.
And then you'll see that it's easy to manipulate this web part. As I scroll over the web part, you'll see that I get this little pen icon here, which is the editing text.
At left.
And allows me to go through and choose these different options and change them as I wish. You'll also see that we have another option here. It says, use the classic version of conversations.
At right.
And so this is referencing back to a different style of feed that we had available for Yammer. This may be a good choice if you want to see all of the conversations that are going on and that whole thread. So you'll see both the thread starter or where the initial post that started the conversation, and then you're going to see all of the replies as part of that too. This feed does not work on the mobile application for SharePoint. So it's something you should be aware of, and it's why it's our classic version. But it can be used in lots of different situations too. So you should try to pick out generally the one that works best for you. In this case, we're going to use the latest version, and that's what we're going to recommend as the default. But if you have options that you need the classic version, that's why we have it there for you too. So I'm going to stick with my top conversations. I'm going to click out of this page and hit publish.
Top right.
I'm going to show you quickly also how to create a new news article, because you can think about how these conversations come about. Maybe you're going to post about an upcoming broadcast or an event that's going to happen, or maybe you're sharing something from a field trip or some other visit where you're publishing out news. I can easily publish news by going to the SharePoint homepage.
Top left.
When I click through onto the SharePoint homepage, you'll see that I get a range of options. This is my personalized feed here. And these news articles that are up here are actually personal to me. So they're being powered by the Microsoft Graph. And it actually allows me to get content that maybe I didn't get promoted to, but it's really understanding what may be of interest to me based on what it is that we're doing with our colleagues. I'm going to create a new news post here.
Right column.
And I can pick out the site that I recently created, in this case, Leadership Connection. And when I create that new news post, then I can look at the different ways to include the web part. Again, specifically to what you're doing for your news article, you can pick out the right kind of feed. It's important to engage that conversation and that community. So think carefully about what kinds of options and what conversations you're trying to showcase here. So I can name my page here, and I think my news article is going to be about a recent field trip, for example.
Field trip.
And so we'll click through here.
On left.
I'm going to add in some nice images. And so I could do a web search, for example, if I wanted to do that. So I'm just going to pick one of these backgrounds here. They're powered by Bing, and they're available with all the Creative Commons information as part of that, too.
Multiple choices.
I can drag to set a focal point on this specific image. So if it's a person's face or whatever I want to show, I can do that. And then I've got this great information here. So I can click through and add a web part here that shows you how to add text or images or other kinds of content too.
At center.
It's a rich publishing set here, so I can copy and paste in things, even bulleted lists from Word. And, you know, we'll talk about the recent travel and what we've learned. So I'm just going to type in some text for now. And then you'll see that I have rich editing capabilities here too. So I can make this bold. I could make it into a headline, for example. So all of those capabilities are built straight in there. I'm going to go ahead and add my conversations now from the community. So I'm scroll through. I can do a couple of different things. I can, if the list looks very long of the different web parts, you can just search for Yammer right here. And so I can do that. And then you'll get this familiar interface.
Yammer conversations.
Okay. Think about where you want the conversations for this specific article to be posted inside of Yammer. So in this case, I'm still going to pick our CEO connection group.
Right column.
And I'm going to say only the latest conversations need to be part of this. And so that card format is automatically there. It's part of the page now that I have for my news articles. And here's the conversations are about. You can see that I can click through and post straight to Yammer right from the web part.
At left.
When I do that, I'm going to add in some text here. Say it's great to hear about this recent field trip. And this will post directly to my Yammer group. So when I click post, and you'll get that message confirmation that we've posted to Yammer. And I can also click through to see the conversation inside of the Yammer group. So it's a really great way to engage people right there, but have all of those conversations be still housed in the same place in Yammer. So all of those conversations will be curated into that CEO connection group, makes it really easy. And then I can see that conversation, continue it here and click like, I can do replies, etc. So I can agree here and say yes. I'm just going to click post. As part of that. And then you'll see that when I go over here, that my conversations have updated on the page. I'm going to refresh the page so you can see the latest as part of this.
Loading Yammer.
There we go. So here's our latest conversation, the one I just posted, and you can see the reply there. And you'll see that the like count and the reply part is in here also. So I think this is a great way to really showcase the capabilities that we have as part of the new Yammer web part inside of SharePoint and think about the ways to build out your social intranet. When we encourage you as you think about the SharePoint sites, whether they're team sites or communication sites, of how you're actually engaging conversations inside of your communities. We have a great range of options as part of the web part, and it's all natively mobile supported. So it makes it easy for anybody to participate as part of your intranet content. I hope this has been helpful to you today and look forward to any questions or comments you may have on how to build your social intranet.
She smiles. Microsoft.